Really visible support might look like, you know, hey, you're great, you're gonna be okay. Invisible emotional support might look something more like, oh, you know, when I'm feeling that way, I kind of think to myself, I know I can do this. So, you know, providing an idea, providing a way to feel better without saying, you need to do this. It's kind of giving a supportive idea without necessarily directing the other person to do one thing or another. Well, a lot of the support research has had a hard time finding when support works and when it doesn't. So sometimes they find that knowing that you've received support actually makes you feel worse, or it doesn't help. So it seems like there's something about knowing you've received support that might make you feel like, oh, this problem is bigger than I thought it was. Or maybe it makes you feel like, oh, now I've received support, I need to do something for this person, maybe feel a little indebted. Or maybe it makes you feel like this person doesn't think I can handle this problem on my own.
It does take two. It's the provider has got to give the right kind of support, but the recipient can't be too aware that it's coming in, otherwise it doesn't work in these situations. And so it's kind of a radical idea, relatively radical idea, to think about the provision of support from the standpoint of the person who needs it and the person who's giving it. But we found basically that you have to understand both people to really understand when this kind of support works well. When one partner in a relationship is going about to do a stressful thing, take the New York bar exam for a law license, for example, that partners, the non-stressed partner who basically did stuff kind of out of sight and out of mind to make the person's day go more smoothly. The person who was under stress, not being aware of what happened, what the partner did, reported less anxiety the following day. And so what makes this study novel, I think, is that we tried to bring it into a lab and look at how couples who are face-to-face discussing a problem actually interact, and what this looks like in terms of actual behavior when people are talking about something directly. And another thing is that this is the first study to really say that it takes both a skillful support provider and a support recipient who's kind of not aware that support's gotten in under the radar. You have to have both those things together for it to work.